Welcome to TCG Player Kickback in just a few hours. Please do support the channel by using the link down below. Well, let's pass it over to Market Watch, shall we? Make sure you guys smash the link, grab out of that subscribe button so you guys don't miss out on more awesome content. I'm drained. I've spent 16 hours sorting cards, putting cards in the master inventory. It has been a mental pain in my butt. But while monitoring all of this retro pack stuff, as going into the day here, you guys want to win a booster pack down below? Leave a comment when you'd be walking away with a booster pack. Sorry, brain's fried. It's been a long day. We do have the official product page up for this, and guess what? Everything that you see here on this page is exactly as we saw it on the previous page. Is it real? I don't know, man. You told me it's on the official Konami page. Do with that what you will. This made me crap my pants, literally. Yeah, there you go. Somebody's gonna love that reference. I was selling these for $7 a playset, literally, the other day. And I look at the MP versions of these, and these are sitting at $8 a piece. I guess the logic with this is people... You know that this has to get a holo print, right? Like, you physically... Like, whether or not it be an OTS, a Battles of Legend, a 10 card, there are three windows for Konami to upgrade this card. And this thing hasn't been reprinted since 2019. Now, given the current Trident Dragion situation, we could punt this straight out the window, and we could maybe not see a holo print. But from what I'm thinking here, with all of my remaining brain power, this card hitting $8-$9 is the craziest thing that I've seen. I'm about to go common digging tomorrow for more of these. That's just free money for a common. I love this game. Shbrutta, the Melodious Maestro. Wow. You know, you've got what, like rares, commons, and some starfoil common for this thing, and we're at the same situation here, $9. And of course, you got people out here trying to sell the 80-year version of this. Guess what? Stop trying to goat people out here, alright? Stop it, alright? There's not really much to say about this. I, once again, think we will see some sort of holo printing for this along the way. Kind of hoping we will. Striker Dragon. $15 for this. So you know why this is going up, right? You know why people are looking at this card. You know, even though it's a one of, it's because literally you make this to step into SP Little Knight and Tenpai. That's your most recent meta application out here for this. Ooh, a stepping stone. All right. I too like having a spot removal on my SP Little Knight. Nothing really too crazy to say about that. Arch Nemesis Protos. You know, I'm also not too surprised about this. Honestly, this is pretty impressive. We've managed to get this card down to $27. Now, if a reprint does come along, you're going to watch this card get knocked down to probably 5 or 6, which is good. But considering the fact this card came back to 1, it hit that initial 30, well, actually it was like 45. And the card has been winding down as a majority of these days have been going on. I'm very happy to report on that, actually, that we have cheap Protoses available to the community right now. And if you're somebody out here that is like, oh, you know, I gotta have this. I want to play me Sword Soul deck. Me Sword Soul deck is tier 1. I mean, yeah, I get it. It is a pretty decent deck right now. By pretty decent, I mean you can win a locals with it if you sack most of your players. But, you know, anything's truly possible out here. I don't know how many of you have been paying attention to Legacy of Destruction. Yeah, boxes are $68 a piece right now. That's terrible on the turnaround of things. But the biggest thing to report on this is most of these Yugi quarter centuries, you had the Silent Magician getting bought out, what was it, earlier last week into this week. We saw the card jet off. You have the Shining Sarcophagus jetting off at what, like 50 or 70, actually. That's pretty stupid. Yeah, you just had one sell for 54. You're up to 70 plus now on this. And of course, I mean, just your little sneak peek down here. Like, the Silent Magician is 63. The Swordsman is 32. That one's okay. Gandora at 47. And of course, the Ties of Friendship is like 25. Of course, the Rota has to be gaining some value. And this is what I talked about with the initial release of this set. People are going to look at these quarter centuries, and they're going to want them, not only because it's Yugi. There's a lot of hype around this deck. I'll be honest with you, it's a very decent, like, tier 2, 2.5 deck that, you know, hand traps can carry you. Shifter's really stupid in the deck. Alright, trust me, I've played enough of this for fun. Alright, it's got its charming moves, and that's why you're seeing these, you know, buyouts actually happening. Well, because one, they were cheap. Two, it's an anime deck. Three, it's Yugi. Don't underestimate the player base out here. This was actually something I just wanted to point out. This showed up. I was searching just kind of on abnormalities out here. One of these sold back on 315 for Gold Series 3. Now, this is not a set you look at every day and go, wow, you know, like, how are we doing out here? No, these rarer products you look at, I mean, look at this, $98. I love the fact that, you know, just the price difference is here. Literally, the most expensive card in this set is the Thunder King, followed by the Alchemist, and then an Infernity Archfiend. When you look at these older sets, it's just the sealed product is so rare at this point. It's just nobody really wants to take the challenge to get it. And, like, Prisma used to have a little bit of value, but not anymore. You know, we've knocked these things down off of a pedestal, the point, you know, we're so much widely available. Even the old JD from this Gold Series has crumbled down. It's not particularly one of my favorite Gold Series in the world, but it's definitely worth looking at just the sealed side of the market. I'll talk more about some of the sealed aspect of things a little bit later on. Destructive Daruma Cannon. Well, if you've not been paying attention to this card, a lot of decks have been choosing to actually use this as a pretty major tech choice right now. You might not have seen it a lot, but trust me, it's ticking around out here. The card's been pretty cool. I mean, hey, basically being able to wipe a Tenpai player, but yes, I know you have to have a field in order to, you have to flip something down in order to, you know, get this thing a rolling. But the card is pretty stupid. I would have loved to have seen this be a QCR. I think a lot of people would have also loved to have seen this card be very, very cheap. It's not the case right now. All right? The card is very, very, very good. And it is warranting its $7 price tag. Oh, speaking of things that are interesting right now, the life cycle on Branded Opening. I didn't realize that this was still like a $4 card. Actually, I'm pretty impressed we're still sitting at like $5 here. This is one of those things that you look at here and you're like, wow. Okay. I also want to give a shout out here to Ancient Gear Ballista. Holy moly. This thing has dropped down. Remember when this was $20? I remember when this was $20. We have plummeted actually down to 10 right now, which almost makes me think we have a reprint coming for this. Wow. You mean to tell me Ballista is going to get a reprint? Yeah. Most likely, this is probably going to get crossed off on the future list here, and we're going to watch this card tank down into probably something a little bit more acceptable, I feel like. For the rest of this market watch, I want to talk a little bit more about Retro Pack. I know a lot of people are very upset that this product was coming down the line. You do have, you know, the differences of copyright, which should be on these. These are also going to be available in 4-pack boxes, and, I mean, that's not, like, the worst thing in the world. I know it's a pretty big FU to the collector's market, and this also means Retro Pack 2 is up on the chopping block, which is kind of interesting. Also, this is looks like it's an NA-only product? I don't know. Don't quote me on that. I'm assuming that it is, which might make this even scarcer for the European side of the market. I don't know how I feel about that, but you know, there's a lot to think about with this set, and I mean an absolute lot. I'm very curious to see how this is going to hold up. I will take a look over the course of the weekend on the probably the Saturday-Sunday Market Watch. We'll take a look at Retro Pack 1 and see how RPO1 is kind of holding up after more and more people have had the chance to shit their pants over this. But for now, I'm tired of shit. I'd like some sleep. leave a comment down below. Tell me what you guys think. You guys have a good rest of your day. All right. Peace out. Patrons, thank you.
Thank you so much for watching. Check out these other videos.